First question. Give me a rundown. Where are we at? What are we doing? What's going on here today?
We're up at Hunters Point Resort, Mille Lacs. We're having a little ice fishing tournament. Seems like we pick the coldest weekend of the year every year to do this, no matter what weekend it is. But it's a great event. We had good turnout, a record turnout this year, so we're happy to be here, no matter how cold it is.
Tell me what inspires you to want to come up here and help be part of it all?
Well, I think, you know, we're so fortunate. At least I'm so fortunate. The position I was in, I got to live my dream and live in a safe country that's protected by so many good people, that be able to kind of give back and then help out you know, military families and their kids with you know, sporting equipment and registration and everything else, where, you know, it's a lot of sports today aren't really affordable for most families. So if we're able to come out and make a difference and help out in that way, every little bit helps.
Super. Have you worked with United Heroes League before?
Yes. So we've been, this is the first year my name has actually been on the tournament. We have been involved the last couple of years, and obviously before COVID hit, we would do a little autograph session before, and then actually get up on stage and hand out you know, prizes and all that kind of stuff. And we've all had to adjust in the last year and a half, so it's a little different. But at the same time, we're able to still hopefully connect with some people, and you know, the excitement and everything else that goes along with it has been very humbling to see so many people turn out for a tournament and to be able to help so many people.
From your time being involved with it, has there been any stories or certain things in particular that you've heard from different military families that have really kind of made you open your eyes to what's taking place and the good things happening?
I think it's more of a general, you know, you hear about, you do a clinic, you know, the United Heroes rink down in Hastings down there with former NHL players, and how many guys come out and you know, help out families, or, and you know, do a clinic at Target Field, you know, doing baseball, and you just have so many different ways of helping large groups of people because your reach is so big, and the organization continues to grow and continues to help so many people. It's been impressive, and I'm glad that I was introduced and you know, invited to be a part of it.
Tell us about the fishing today.
we're still fishing. We're not doing a whole lot of catching, so it's one of those things where, you know, you sit there and you got how much technology you have, whether you're watching the fish swim by and not bite your little minnow you got in the water, or, you know, you're kind of just following along as it goes. But I got my son with me, and his patience is not quite as good as mine. So he's got his skates on. He's skating around waiting for the fish to bite. But we'll see what the winter brings in. And either way, we're here. We're having fun. And it's a better day of being anywhere else.
Awesome. I got to ask, so people might be wondering, what have you been up to? What's been going on since you retired, and what's shaking in Justin's world?
Well, we have five kids, so there's three of them playing hockey now, and we'll have three playing softball and baseball in the summer, and assistant coach with wherever they'll let me come around. So doing that, and then doing some stuff with the twins, doing TV. Last year was a little different year. We were supposed to do 60 games, and the season ended up only being 60 games. So this year, hoping to have a regular schedule, and I'll do 66 games on TV with Twins TV, and then kind of spread that out throughout the year, so it allows me to still coach but also still be around the game and still be around the Twins and do what I love to do, and then also be able to spend time with my family as well. So been busy, but I wouldn't want it any other way.
Awesome. And that's still right here in Minnesota is where you're living?
Yeah, we decided to make our home in Minnesota, and you know, good people here, so it's a great place to raise a family. And when we need to, we can escape to warmer places, but we always end up back here.
Last question for you, Justin. Anything that we didn't touch on yet that you feel is important, whether it be about this event in particular, military families, Twins baseball, whatever you feel is maybe something that we didn't cover, if it's important?
Yeah, I think, you know, just the most important thing for me is that we're able to give back to people who sacrifice so much. I mean, whether it's obviously not the same thing as you know, serving and going, you know, whether it's overseas or wherever it is, and protecting and keeping everyone safe here, it's not quite the same as being able to provide, you know, sport opportunities and different things like that. But at the same time, every little bit makes a difference, and we're grateful to whoever shows up and supports this great organization. So.